वेलकम टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर। माई सेल्फ अतुल कुमार, वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस, राजीव गांधी मेमोरियल, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, जोगिंदर नगर। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट रजिस्टर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। सो रजिस्टर्स आर यूज बाय द माइक्रो प्रोसेसर फॉर टेम्परेरी स्टोरेज एंड मैनिपुलेशन ऑफ डाटा एंड इंस्ट्रक्शंस। डाटा रिमेन इन द रजिस्टर till they send to the memory or input-output devices. So registers are basically the memory storage devices, and any intermediate result or data is stored in the register before and after the CPU processing. So there are different kinds of registers. One is accumulator register, or it is also known as processor register. Second one is general purpose register. Third one is special purpose register. General purpose registers are used mainly for general purpose task, and specific purpose registers are used mainly for specific purpose task or to perform a specific operation. So I have discussed these registers in detail in previous video lecture. Kindly go through these lectures. And when a large number of registers are included in the CPU, they are connected by common bus to make them more efficient. So this one is the bus organization of several internal processor registers. As we can see in the diagram, there are seven registers starting from R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 and R7. There is a decoder, and decoder is of 3x8, means it has a input of 3 lines and output of 7 lines. There is also a, SMA, and that is given to M1, and SMB that is given to M2, and M1 and M2 are here are multiplexers, and multiplexers, the output of multiplexer is given to bus B1, and multiplexer B2 is given to bus B2, and these two buses are connected to ALU, arithmetic logic unit, and the output of arithmetic logic unit is given to the seven registers R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 and R7, and also the output is taken as a output. So the output of each register is connected to two multiplexers, resulting in the formation of two buses, V1 and B2, as shown in diagram here. There is a bus is B1 and this one is a bus B2, and the selection line in each line select input data for particular bus or a register. The bus B1 and B2 are attached to the ALU, common ALU, that is a arithmetic logic unit. As we can see here in the diagram, bus B1 and B2 are connected to a arithmetic logic unit in bus organization of a registers. The arithmetic and logic micro operations are performed in arithmetic logic unit, and the result is available for the output data as well as goes into the input of the registers. As we can see in the diagram, it is the output of ALU is available as a output data here. As we can see here, output data here, and also it is given to the input to the registers. So as there are different binary selection variables used in bus organization of several internal processor registers. So first binary selection variable is SMA, and it places the content of first register into B1. So the content of first register R1 is placed into the bus B1 with the help of SMA, and the there is another selection variable SMB, and it places the content of the second register in bus B2. So SMB is used to place the content of second register, that is M2, into the bus B2. AUS is the another binary selection variable. It provide operation to be performed, and DDS is another binary selection variable. The purpose of this is to transfer the content of output bus into the registers. So DDS is used to transfer the content of output bus into the registers R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 and R7. So there is also another term used in register organization, that is a control word. And control word is the combined value of 14 selection input, and these selection inputs include SMA, SMB, DDS and AOS. So SMA is in control word, SMA is of 3 bits, SMB of 3 bits, DDS of 3 bits and AOS is of 5 bits. So when we add 3 with 3 of SMB with 3 of DDS and 5 of AOS, then the result is 14. 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, 3 is 14, and this one is the combined value of 14 selection inputs, which is known as control word. So next, as we see in the slides, we can see different encoding of register selection lines. So to encode a binary code 000, that is equivalent to decimal value 0, we have input of SMA as R1, we have input of SMB as R2 and DDS of R1. Similarly, to code binary code 001, that is a equivalent value of 1, we have a SMA of R2 and input to SMB is from register R2, and from to DDS it is from R2. So on, we can also create the binary codes for other values. So in this table, in the next table, this one is the encoding of ALU operations, and considering the functions of F of variable A and B. So as we can see in the previous slide, AOS is of 5 bits, so here the binary code is also of 5 bits, and the operation, suppose the first operation is F is equal to A, and it is represented in the form of symbol as TSF. The second binary code is 401, and the operation for this F is A plus 1, as we have used two variables A and B, and the symbol used for this operation is INR. Similarly, you can see various kind of AOS codes and different operations in this table with the help and their representation as a symbol. So next is the different example of micro operations. So control word for a given micro operation can be derived from a selection variable. So these are some examples. Suppose we have a micro operation R1 implies R2 plus R3. For this, SMA used is R2 register as input, SMB use register input R3 as input, DDS use R1 as input, and AOS as add, and the control word used here is 010011001000010. So similarly, for other operation, you can refer to this table 6.3. So other examples of micro operation involves require a control word of 14 bits. As we can see in the previous slide, the control word is of 14 bits, 3 bits for SMA, 3 bits for SMB, 3 bits for DDS, and 5 bits for AOS. So which can be derived from for the selection variable, Hence, we can say that the micropation is specified by a control word of 14 bits. So, control word is always of 14 bits in case of register organization. So, here it explained with the help of example. Suppose we have a micro operation that suppresses the content of R2 and R3 and places the contents in register R1. The meaning of this operation is that the contents of R2 is subtracted, or the content of R3 is subtracted from content of R2, and the result of R2 minus R3 is placed in this register, that is R1. So as shown in slide, it specify R2 as a input of ALU, R3 as a B input of ALU, and R1 as a destination register, and ALU operation to subtract R2 minus R3, as R2 minus R3 is always performed in ALU. Thus, the control word is specified by 4 fields, and the corresponding binary value for each field is obtained from the encoding listing in the table 6.1 and 6.2 as shown in the previous slide. Next, there is another example of micro operation for CPU. These are the different example, like R1 implies R2 minus R3, R4 implies R4 union R5, and shown in this slide. And this one is the symbolic representations or symbolic designations, and the control used word used for these micro operations is 010, 011, 001, and 00100. So this basically depends upon the processor, and what kind of processor we are using, and what kind of control unit, and what kind of hardware that is placed, and how many registers are available in that kind of microprocessor. So when any kind of input of ALU is not used by the micro operation, as we have seen in this table, so it is always represented the field with the help of dash, and we assign 000000 to any unused field when formulating the binary control word. Thanks for watching this video lecture.